Good morning, students. Today we are going to learn a new chapter in your English core textbook. Okay, so the name of the chapter is Uncle Podger Hangs a Picture. Uncle Podger Hangs a Picture. So this was a short story written by Jerome K. Jerome. Okay, he is a famous writer and let us learn about him. So this is Jerome K. Jerome and he was born in 1859 and he died in 1927. He was an English writer and humorist. He was born in United Kingdom. Okay, so his famous works were Three Men in a Boat, and this is the work which we are taking our short story from. Okay, the short story that we are learning, that is Uncle Podger Hangs a Picture, was taken. These are excerpt from this collection of short stories, that is Three Men in a Boat. The other two are essays. First one is Idle Thoughts of an Idle Fellow, and the second one is Second Thoughts of an Idle Fellow. Okay, so these are the famous works of Jerome K. Jerome. Now let us move into the chapter. Take page number 67 in your textbook. Page number 67. Okay, so introduction itself. Uncle Podger loved to do jobs or chores at home, but with confusion and chaos. He had the entire household running around, attending to him while he stood and commanded or ordered as if he was an expert in that job. So what is the speciality of Uncle Podger? First of all, it is an account about Uncle Podger. What kind of a person he is. Okay, so Uncle Podger is the person who loved to do jobs or course. Course means jobs itself. Okay, everything which we do at home and all, small kind of jobs. So he loved to do jobs or course at home, but with a little confusion and chaos. So that is the problem with Uncle Podger. He loves to do all these jobs, but he always does it with some kind of confusion. He makes confusion and chaos. Chaos means noisy problems. Okay, he makes problems, he makes noise, and he makes the entire household running around, attending to him while he stood and commanded as if he was an expert in that job. So what did he do? He had the entire household running around. Okay, he is going to do some kind of a job and he is going to make the entire household. The entire household means all the people inside the house. Okay, he is going to make every people inside the house run around and attend to him. Okay, he is going to do something. He needs a lot of people around him to help with him. So what is he doing? He is going to do something and he is going to stand there and command. Command means order someone to do something. He is going to order everyone else to do this and that for him. Okay, and he was an expert in that job. Okay, he only ordered or commanded. He was an expert in commanding others to do this and that, but he will not do anything at all. He will only stand there and order. Now let us move into the chapter. Whenever Uncle Podger undertook a job at home, there was a lot of commotion. So we already told that whenever Uncle Podger is doing something, there will be confusion and chaos. So here the speaker is telling that whenever Uncle Podger undertook a job at home, that means he is going to do a job at home, he made a lot of commotion. Commotion means sudden noisy confusion or excitement. He made a lot of noisy confusion and excitement. Okay, he had a lot of excitement and he made a lot of confusion and noise while doing all that. One day, a picture came from the frame maker. It was in the dining room waiting to be put up on one of the walls. Aunt Maria asked, Who is going to hang the picture? Oh, you leave that to me, said Uncle Podger. None of you should worry about that. I will put it up. So what did he do? What happened again? One day a picture came from the frame maker. One day a picture came from the frame maker. Frame maker is the person who makes frames for pictures, mirrors and all such things. Okay. So one day a picture came from the wall maker and it was sitting in the dining room and it was waiting for someone to come and pick it up and hang it on the wall. Aunt Maria asked, who is going to hang the picture? So Aunt Maria, what did she do? She was asking, who is going to hang this picture on the wall? Oh, you leave that to me, said Uncle Podger. None of you should worry about that. I will put it up. So what did he do? He is agreeing to do the job. He is telling that, don't worry, you don't have to worry about worry at all. You just leave it to me. I will hang the picture on the wall without making any problems. Then he began. He sent the girl out for 6 penny worth of nails and then one of the boys after her to tell what size to get. Now, will you go and get my hammer? He shouted. Tom, you bring me the rule. I shall want the step ladder and I better have the kitchen stool. I better have the kitchen stool too. Tim, you run round to Mr. Gurgles and borrow his spirit level. So he is ordering others to do things. First, what did he do? He sent a girl out for 6 penny worth of nails. Penny worth is a small amount. Okay, penny worth means as much as one can buy with a penny. Penny is a small amount and penny worth means something which we can buy with that small amount of penny. Okay, so he sent a girl to buy 6 penny worth of things. Nails. Okay, so whenever we are sending someone to do buy something, for example, if we are sending someone to buy some sugar, we should tell them what the amount or quantity should be. Okay, you just not tell them to buy sugar. You tell them to buy 1 kg of or 1 kilogram of sugar. Likewise, you have to tell, right? But Uncle Podger did not do that. He forgot to tell that. And after sending the girl to buy the nails, he had to send another boy to send after her to tell her what size of nail she should be getting. Okay, so he is not doing the job at one go. He is making all others around him to do the jobs. Now, will you go and get my hammer? Now, he is shouting for another tool, the hammer. He wants the hammer. He shouted, Tom, you bring me the rule. I shall want the step ladder and I better have the kitchen stool. After that, he is ordering Tom. Okay, so he is ordering Tom to bring him the rule. Rule means the scale which we use to measure. Okay, so he is ordering him to bring the rule and then he wants the step ladder too. Step ladder is the ladder which we use to climb upon walls. And then after that, he is asking for kitchen stool. Kitchen stool means the stool we use at home. Okay, so after that, Tim, you run round to Mr. Goggles and borrow his spirit level. What is a spirit level? A glass tube partly filled with liquid with a bubble of air inside. So that is a spirit level. Okay, after telling Tom to bring all these things, he is asking Tim to run to Mr. Goggles. He is not only making the people in his home work for him, he is also asking to buy or borrow something from the neighborhood also. Okay, so next he is asking for the spirit level. Spirit level is a glass tube partly filled with the liquid. Partly means half filled with the a liquid form of substance. Then there is also a single air bubble in it. It is used for measuring. Okay, so it is also used for measuring. So he is sending all these children to bring things for him. So now let us look into the tools he have ordered. First, he ordered for a nail. The picture in the middle is the nail. then the harbor, the step ladder, and the spirit level. These are the tools which he ordered the children to bring for him. Okay, a hammer, a nail, step ladder, and the spirit level. Now, don't you go, Maria, because I shall want somebody to hold the light. When the girl comes back, she must go out again for a bit of picture code. And Tom, where is Tom? Tom, you come here. I shall want you to hand me the picture. So, next step, he is ordering Maria. He didn't stop with that. He is ordering Maria because I shall want somebody to hold the light. He wants Maria to hold the light so he can put the nail on the wall properly. So, he is asking Maria to accompany him. When the girl comes back, she must go out again for a bit of picture code. And Tom, so he already ordered a girl to buy some nails, right? So he is telling that when that girl comes back, she must again go out again. Okay, she must go out again for what? For a bit of picture cord. And Tom, picture cord means a measuring instrument itself. Okay, so next he is telling that after the girl brings the nail, she has to go out again and she has to bring the picture cord. And then he is again asking for Tom. Tom, where is Tom? Tom, you come here. I shall want you to hand me the picture. He already gave a job to Tom. Okay, he already gave a job for Tom to do. But he is not stopping with that. He is again ordering and shouting at Tom. Where are you, Tom? Come here. I want you to hand me the picture. So I am going to step on the step ladder and I want someone to hand me the picture. So you have to stay here itself. Don't go anywhere. You have to stay here. He is ordering Tom and Maria to accompany him. Now, then he lifted the picture and dropped it. Okay, so what did Tom brought the picture to him and he lifted the picture. Uncle Porter lifted the picture and it slipped from his hand. He dropped it. Okay, he dropped it down and it came out of the frame. He tried to save the glass and cut himself. So what happened? It came out of the frame. The picture came out of the frame while all this commotion was happening. Okay. So, Uncle Porja slipped his hand and he dropped the picture and the picture came out of the frame. And while he was trying to rescue or help the picture or save the glass, he cut himself. He tried to not break the glass of the picture and while doing that, he cut himself. That means he injured his hand. Then he hopped around the room looking for his handkerchief. Okay, so when he cut his hand, a lot of blood is coming out. So he had to cover it with something. So what did he do? He hopped around the room. Hop means moved by jumping on one foot. Okay, he was jumping on one foot. Then he lifted the picture and dropped it. It came out of a frame. He tried to save the glass and cut himself. Then he hopped around the room looking for his handkerchief. What did he do? He lifted the picture. He, Uncle Porja, lifted the picture and accidentally dropped it. He slipped his hand and he accidentally dropped the picture. And the picture came out of the picture frame. Okay, the picture came out of the picture frame and he tried to save the glass from breaking. Okay, he was trying to save the glass of the picture from breaking and while he was doing that, he cut his hand. That means he made an injury on his hand and it started to bleed. Okay, whenever you cut your hand, it starts to bleed. What did he do? Then he hopped around the room looking for his handkerchief. He hopped around the room looking for his handkerchief. Hopped means move by jumping on one foot. Okay, if you are jumping on one foot and moving around the room, then it is hopping. So, when he realized that he cut himself on his hand because of the glass. He started hopping or jumping around the room in one foot. And what was he looking for? He was looking for his handkerchief because he was bleeding and he wanted to cover his wound. He wanted to cover his wound and he was hopping around the room looking for his handkerchief. He couldn't find it because it was in the pocket of the car he had taken off. So what happened? Even though he was hopping around the room and looking for his handkerchief very desperately, he could not find it. What was the reason? He kept the handkerchief in the pocket which he wore. Okay, wearing a coat and he took off. That means he took off the coat and put it somewhere. And he does not remember. But the problem was, he did not know where he had put the coat. So he kept his handkerchief in the pocket of the coat, which he removed some time ago. And he does not remember where he put the coat. So it is the mistake made by Uncle Podger. Look what he is going to do. All the house had to stop looking for his tools and start looking for his coat. Okay, so he already ordered everyone to search for something else. That means search for some kind of tools to take him that, take him this. Likewise, he was ordering others to bring him his tools. So now he ordered them to stop all that activities. They all should stop looking for their tools. And what should they do? They have to look for his coat. They should start to look for his coat. While they were doing so, he bullied them. Okay, so what did he do? So he ordered everyone to find his coat so that he can take the handkerchief and cover his wound. He was ordering them to search for his coat. And while they were searching for his coat, what was he doing? He bullied them. Bullied means frightened someone. So he, while others were searching for his coat, what was he doing? He was frightening them. He was simply sitting down there and he was frightening them. He was frightening them, telling that if you did not find the coat, I will do that. Likewise, and likewise, he was scolding and frightening them. Does anyone in this house know where my coat is? I never came across such a set of people in all my life. Upon my word, I didn't. So many of you, and you can't find a coat that I took off not even 5 minutes ago. Then he got up and found out that he had been sitting on it. So what happened? He is scolding. Okay, he is scolding all the people who are searching for his coat. Doesn't anyone in this house know where my coat is? So whose mistake is that? Okay, first of all, whose mistake is that? He forgot where he kept his coat. Okay, it is his own responsibility. But he is putting it on others. And he is asking them, doesn't anyone in this house know where my coat is? Doesn't anyone know? I never came across such a set of people in all my life. And then after that, he is degrading them. And he is scolding them. I never came across such a set of people in all my life. That means I have never seen this kind of bad people who could not do a thing properly in my whole life. Upon my word, I didn't. He is then swearing. Okay, he is swearing that upon my word, I am swearing upon my own word and I am promising that I have never seen these kind of people in my whole life. So many of you, and you can't find it. Coat that I took off not even 5 minutes ago. And then he is scolding them like, so many of you, there are a lot of people here and no one of you could find a coat that I have removed just 5 minutes ago. So the problem is that he does not remember that he where he kept the coat which he removed 5 minutes ago, but he wants others to find out where they kept, where they can find it. Okay, he is scolding and telling them that they have to find it and it is their fault that they could not find the coat until now. Then he got up and found out that he had been sitting on it. Okay, so all this time he he was scolding others and blaming them for not finding his God. And at the end of it, he stood up from where he was sitting and realized that all this time he have been sitting upon that cot itself. Okay, he was sitting upon that cot and he was scolding others or blaming others to find his cot for him. You can give up. He called out. Okay, so after that he have to save his face. So he is telling, you can give up. Give up means to stop trying to do something. You can stop searching for my cot. He called out, I have found it myself. Might just as well ask the cat to find anything than expect you people to find it. So even though the mistake is in his own hands, he is not ready to accept it. He is still blaming others. So he is telling, I have found it myself. So he is telling, it's like he have done something very great. So he is telling, I have found my cot myself without any of yours help. Okay. Might just as well ask the cat to find anything than expect you people to find it. So he is again blaming them. So he is telling them that I should have asked the cat in my house to find my cot. Okay, it would have been better than asking you people to search for my cot. You have no power or you could not find my cot. So I think that it should have been better if I asked a cat in this home to search for my cot. Then the cat would have found it for me, but not you people. Okay, so it was all his fault, but even though he is blaming all of these things upon the others in the family. When half an hour had been spent in tying up his finger and a new glass had been brought as well as the tools, the ladder, the stool and the candle, he had another go. The whole family, including the girl and the charwoman, stood around in a semicircle ready to help. Two people had to hold the stool, a third helped and the fourth passed him up the hammer. He took hold of the nail and dropped it. So what is happening now? When half an hour had been spent, okay, after finding his cot, he took out the handkerchief and he spent almost half an hour tying up his wound with the kerchief, and he also bought a new glass to put up for the picture. Okay, after half an hour, he find the other tools. Okay, the other people had also brought the other tools. He did not do anything. All of these things had to be done by the others at home. So they bought all the tools and they also found the ladder, the stool and the candle. And after finding all these things, after having all things at his hand, he had another go. That means he started doing this again. The whole family, including the girl and the charwoman, stood round in a semicircle. Okay, so every people in the family had to be there for him to put a nail on the wall. Okay, so the whole family, including the girl from the first para, and the charwoman. Who is a charwoman? A woman whose job is to clean the house. Okay, so the woman who is appointed or who is in charge of cleaning the house is called a charwoman. Okay, so the girl and the charwoman and every other members in the house had to stand around the stool in a semicircle. Semicircle means the half portion of a circle. Okay, they stood around the stool in a semicircle position, ready to help. They were all ready to help Uncle Podger with hanging that picture. Two people had to hold the stool. Okay, he was standing on a stool and he wanted two people to hold the stool. A third helped and fourth passed him up the hammer. Okay, so the third one also helped with the stool and then the fourth person passed him, that means gave him the hammer. He took hold of the nail and dropped it. So what did he do? Someone passed him the hammer and he took the nail for putting it on the wall and he slipped that from his hand again and he lost the nail. He dropped the nail down and he lost it. Then he said in an injured tone, now the nail is gone. So he is blaming again others. Okay, it was his fault that he could not hold the nail properly. But then he is again blaming the others. There, what have you done? The nail is gone now. We all had to go down on our knees and hunt for it while he stood on the stool and complained. I want to know, he said, if I am to be kept here all evening. The nail was found at last, but by that time he had lost the hammer. So what happened then? He had lost the nail. So what happened? He stood on the stool itself. He is the person who lost the nail, but he stood on the stool itself, and all those who accompanied him on helping him with putting the nail on the wall had to search for the nail. He only stood there and he complained. Complaint means said that one was annoyed or unhappy about something. Okay, he was unhappy about others because they could not find the nail. It was, he is telling that it was not his fault to drop it, but it was the fault of others who also could not find the nail. And then he is telling, I want to know whether I am going to be kept here all evening. Okay, are you going to keep me here on the stool for the whole evening? Why can't you find the nail? He is calling others. Okay, why can't you find the nail? I am standing here for the whole evening. Find it fast. Okay. The nail was found at last, but by that time he had lost the hammer. So what happened next? They all searched very hard and they found the nail. And what happened next? By the time they found the nail, Uncle Podger has lost the hammer. Okay, so now first he has lost the handkerchief, then the nail, now he has lost the hammer. Where is the hammer? What did I do with the hammer? Great heavens, so many of you just hanging around here and you don't know what I did with the hammer. So now again he is holding. Where is the hammer? Okay, he lost the hammer and he is calling others. Where is the hammer? What did I do with the hammer? Okay, I don't remember what I do with the hammer. Great heavens, that means he is calling for the gods. Great heavens, so many of you are here and you are just hanging around all here and you don't know what I did with the hammer. So it is not his fault that he lost the hammer. It is the fault of others that they did not notice what Uncle Podger have done with the hammer. So he is again scolding and blaming others on what he has done. We found the hammer for him, but by then he had lost sight of the mark he had made on the wall where the nail was to go in. Each of us tried to help him, but to no avail. So what happened next? They found the hammer. Okay, the speaker is telling that at last somehow they found the hammer, and by that time what happened? It became dark and he lost sight of the mark where he had made the mark on the wall to put up the nail. Okay, so he put up a mark on the wall to put the nail on it, and he had lost sight of it because it was taking too long and it became dark and he could not see the mark anymore. Each of us tried to help him, but to no avail. Okay, so Uncle Podger is an elderly person. He could not see the mark properly. So all the others are trying to help him, but it was of no avail. No avail means with little or no success. But because it was not successful for them to make him find the mark, they wanted to help him with finding the mark, but it was not successful at all. He used a bit of string trying to reach a point 3 inches beyond what was possible for him to reach. The string slipped and down he slid onto the piano. A really fine musical effect being produced by the suddenness with which his head and body struck all the notes at the same time. Okay, so after that, what did he do? He used a bit of a string. Okay, he used a string and he was trying to reach the point with the 3 inches beyond what was possible for him to reach. Okay, he was trying to measure the wall or the mark with a string, and while doing it, he slipped again. He slipped on the string again, and what did he do? He fell down. Okay, he fell down or he slid down directly to the piano. Piano which was kept near him. Piano is a musical instrument. Okay, so he fell down directly onto the piano. A really fine musical effect being produced by the suddenness. Okay, so he fell on the piano very suddenly. Suddenness means something which happened suddenly and unexpectedly. So sir, this thing, that means Uncle Podger falling down was an unexpected and sudden thing. Okay, so when it was happening, when he was falling down, on when he fell down directly onto the piano, a fine musical effect was produced because all the notes were pressed up at the same time, because his body and his head was pressed up at the same time to the keys of the piano. Okay, so when his body struck the piano, a very fine and beautiful music sound was heard. Again another commotion caused by Uncle Podger. After almost an hour, Uncle Podger got the spot fixed again. Okay, so after all of this commotion and after almost another hour, Uncle Podger got the spot. That means he found the spot where he put the mark. Okay, he put the point of the nail on it with his left hand and took the hammer in his right hand. Okay, so what did he do now? He find out the spot where he put the mark to put the nail, and he took the nail on his left hand and put it on the mark, and after that he took the hammer on his right hand and he was trying to blow on it. Then with the first blow, he smashed his thumb and dropped the hammer on somebody's toes. Okay, so he held the nail and he smashed on it. That means he was trying to blow directly onto the nail. And what happened? He smashed his thumb. Smash means block something by hitting really. And with the pain which caused by that, he dropped the hammer on somebody's jaws. Okay, so he not only hurt himself by smashing the hammer on his own hands, but he also dropped the hammer onto someone else's toes. Okay, he also caused harm for someone else now. Aunt Maria heaved a sigh, let out a deep breath, and said, "Next time, I want to be told when Uncle Podger is going to drive a nail into the board. I will go and spend a week with my mother while it is being done." Okay, so next year, after doing all of this thing, Aunt Maria is being sarcastic. Okay, so she is making fun out of Uncle Podger. She heaved a sigh. Heaved a sigh means let out a deep breath. Okay, let out a brief deep breath with a noise. Okay, after making such a sigh, she said, what did she say? "Next time, if Uncle Podger is going to put a nail on the board, okay, next time when you understand that he is, or Uncle Podger is going to put a nail on the board, what am I going to do? I will go and spend a week with my mother." Okay, I will go and spend a week with my mother while he put a nail on the wall, because I cannot stand him doing this. It is making a lot of commotion. It is better to be staying at my mom's home until he is putting on the nail on the wall. "Oh, you woman, you make such a fuss over everything," Uncle Porter said. "I like doing a little job like this." So even after causing all of this, he is telling that, "You women, okay, this is the problem with women. You make such a fuss over everything." Fuss means unnecessary excitement. Okay, so he is telling that it is the common nature of women to make unnecessary fuss over small things and everything. So he is telling that what he is doing now is causing unnecessary fuss and not stating the obvious. That means he is telling that she is not saying the right thing, but she is only fussing over everything what we are doing. Uncle Podger said, "I like doing a little job like this." After that, he is telling that I like to do little jobs like this. Okay, so think yourself, is he doing a little job? No, it is actually a little job but he is making it a big deal. Okay, he is making it into a large or huge commercial. About midnight, the picture was a very crooked and insecure, and everybody very tired and miserable except Uncle Podger. Okay, so what happened about midnight? That means it was almost 12 in the morning. The picture was put up on the wall, and what was wrong with it? It was very crooked. Crooked means it was not sitting straight. Okay, it was very crooked and insecure. Insecure means it might fall down any time. Okay, crooked means not in a straight line, and insecure means unsafe, which means it might fall down any time. And everybody very tired and miserable except Uncle Podger. So even after the picture was put up on the wall, everybody was tired. It was a small job, but everybody was tired and miserable. Miserable means very unhappy and uncomfortable. Okay, so everybody in the house were very unhappy, uncomfortable and tired except for Uncle Podger. Why? Because he was only standing there and ordering others to do things. He was not doing anything. So he was not tired, but all the others at his home was extremely tired. "There you are," he said, stepping heavily off the stool onto the charwoman's cones and surveying the mess he had with the pride. "Why? Some people would have paid a man to do a little thing like that." So what did he do? After all putting up the picture on the wall, he's telling, "There you are." Okay, so whenever you have done something, you will say, "There you are." Okay, likewise, Uncle Podger is telling, "There you are," he said, stepping heavily off the stool. That means he jumped down from the stool. And what did he do? Even then, he is making a problem. He stepped right onto the charwoman's cones. Cones means a hard swelling type of thing seen on your toes. Okay, seen on your toes. It is because of work and all. There will be a swelling or hard kind of skin and a swelling which looks like this cones. Okay, so these are called cones. And he stepped onto the toes of the charwoman and surveying the mess. And he is now surveying the mess that he have created. Mess means a dirty or untidy condition. Okay, so he have done the job, but he have made a complete mess over the house he had made with the pride. Okay, so he was looking at all the mess that he have done with complete pride. He was very happy about what he have done, and he is assuring himself now. Why? Some people would have paid a man to do a little thing like that. Okay, so now he is telling that someone would have to pay someone else to put a nail on the wall and hang a picture on it. Okay, we should have to pay for that. Okay, it is better that I could do all of these kind of small things by my own. He is reassuring himself. So that's all the story. Okay, so Uncle Podger is a person who likes to do all kinds of jobs at home, but while doing that, he always makes a lot kind of commotion. So this story was about Uncle Podger trying to put up a picture or hang a picture on the wall, and he had made a complete commotion. He ordered everyone else to do his job, and he was ordering, even though he was at fault, he was ordering and blaming others for making it his fault. Okay, so this is the story of Uncle Podger who was hanging a picture. So this was a story from Three Men in a Pot by Jerome K. Jerome. Okay, so this is the chapter 3 of Three Men in a Pot. Uncle Podger hangs a picture. This is a short story, and it's the third chapter of the collection of short stories named Three Men in a Pot, written by Jerome K. Jerome. So that's all about the story.